Think Research Tools is organized by projects. You can, in addition to the project that you created with this functionality to set up a new project, you can just type in a domain and run a backlink analysis, a quick backlink check for that domain and many others. Every project has settings that you can change here. Here's the launcher. You can use the launcher to start all the LRT classic tools. All the 25 tools are in here. And of course, when you click on them to start it, you will see a user interface, the documentation to the user interface, training videos, and much more. We got link crawl budget that measures how much quota, crawling quota you have left. If you want to go back to LRT classic, it's here, and you can actually switch back and forth between classic and smart. All the data is in there and will remain. New functionalities we report here, and then here's a couple useful links to our documentation and of course your account settings. Now to the main navigation. Besides the home, the welcome screen, and the overview of your reports, we got a domain overview, the dashboard that we already briefly explained in a report in a video. When we look at a link profile for a domain, we see a histogram here, and these link profile histogram are a key feature of Link Research Tools. We don't know any other product that allows you to drill deep into your backlink profile by all these different metrics. And some of these metrics are key metrics that only Link Research Tools has. What is new in LRT Smart is not only that you can filter and show slices for a specific filter slice, let's say in this case, all the links that were not disavowed, or here, all the links going to pages that are actually 404. But we can combine these filter tabs by using Control and click. So we could say all the links going to the target 404s that are broken by themselves. So broken links going to broken pages. That's pretty cool, isn't it? And these filters, we have a couple more. And these smart filters you can always extend by yourself. So if you come up with additional rules, and let's say you want here filter by the anchor text or even add group filter criteria, you can do that here in the filter builder and then save this filter as a new filter. And this new filter, you can then make a favorite to show here as a tab. So that's a quick primer on how the filters work. This is a global filter system that works across the whole system. And as you'll notice, when you mouse over this embedded filter here, you see the detailed criteria that are behind this embedded filter. So you can combine and nest filters in a very fancy way and solve a lot of interesting questions with that. Now, the filter that we set up here works on all these other areas of link data. For example, here, the anchor texts. All the keywords that are linking to the domain coming from broken links going to broken pages. Now let's get rid of this filter here. Now you see how this updates, and also the counters here in the sidebar updated. So we always have a clear understanding of what we see filtered here, counted here, and being in detail here in the middle. And we have our filters that we created before here, just like in other parts of the application. Now, when we go through these anchor text tables, that we have keyword classifications. Keyword classification can be done in bulk, can be done one by one by clicking these buttons, or it could be done with the automated keyword classification that you can set up in the system when crawling. Link fragments show you all the keywords that are behind anchor links. So named anchors is another name for it. Source TLDs shows you the source extensions. So the domains linking to you coming from different countries, different TLDs. Like here we got a lot of XYZ links, and those are probably spammy. Domains is pretty self-explanatory, and you can see all these different domains where we have links. Oh, look, we even got a link on Google.com. Now, this is time to introduce the link table. You see our link table has the filters here again, and we can page through the data really quick. Given that we have thousands and tens of thousands of domains, we optimize this for the fastest possible navigation. What you maybe not see is that we have a vertical scroll bar here with a fixed column for the source domain and here for the ratings and the disavow actions. You can add new columns, new source metrics, new target metrics. We got over 150 different SEO metrics, and some of them are as simple as the source domain name, and others are key features of link research tools like the link velocity trends or detail root domain specifications, AdSense IDs, power trust, title rank, just to name a few. And don't worry if this sounds overwhelming. We have a very detailed documentation of all these metrics and where they come from and what they mean. And when we go further to the source pages, we now see all the source pages where we have links on. Previously, we saw those 27,000 source domains. Now we see where the links are on, so the actual pages. However, when we look at that table, we see there's another table called links, and that one lists all the links that we have, because sometimes there are multiple links on a page. And you see some of the very useful and unique criteria that we extract. So for example, here we have the link location where we tell you, is that link in the content, in the paragraph, somewhere in the footer, in the sidebar. Detox risk is our criteria, for example, to measure the toxicity, the risk of a link. And there's many more here. And you may notice this table is a lot wider, and we haven't even enabled all the metrics. Of course, for the links, we have a lot more different metrics. And we have a lot of documentation, a lot of videos about these different metrics that you can utilize in LRT. Now, while we're here looking at links, it's maybe interesting to review the detail view, because here we see not just where the link is coming from, but also what it said when we last crawled it and where it's going to. And here you can see that we are actually looking at a link that goes to a non-secure page, redirecting with a 301 to an actual success page, returning the content. Now, we call this the redirect trace, and we have redirect trace for all the links that we crawled. We keep a history of error codes, network error codes, and many more. And guess what? We can filter by all these criteria. So we can say things like more than 5 target hops is a criteria that we set up as a filter. And right now, we found the 99 links out of the 100,000 something that have more than 5 redirects on the target page. Look at that. This link is not connecting at the moment. It's a network error. But we see how this link redirects between different domains, from linkresearchtools.com to linkdetox.com, back and forth between a landing page and another landing page and another landing page for an ebook that we don't provide at the moment. Now, if that's not a waste of link juice, I don't know what. The good news is this is actually a bad link, and we want to disavow that whole root domain. So in this case, it's actually good that we have this large source and target redirect trace. In other cases where we have good links, or let's say not so bad links with a below average risk here, the redirect trace is even longer. Look at that. It's unbelievable. All self-made problems. But Link Research Tools helps you find them. And you probably didn't see that, but this filter here is also related to a link issue that we have in our link issues here. The automated recommendations, the redirects on the target page, 36,000 redirects are on target pages. So, of course, that's a broader criteria. This shows us all the target pages that have redirects. And I can tell you, we don't have 36,000 target pages. So that means we have some on-site structure, some technical SEO problem for sure. Yeah, but going back, you don't see this. You can always navigate in Link Research Tools with the browser back and forth. You can copy paste the links up there to go directly to this view, or you can copy a reference to this specific link. And then when you start a new tab, you get to the demo report again. And when you copy this URL and share it with a friend or with a teammate, he can see exactly what you see here. And sometimes this includes, of course, the sorting and filter criteria and additional columns that you used. So this is a very useful way to share your insights. Now, to something else, you notice how our cursor blinks all the time. And this is a feature that we have where you can select parts of the URLs. And when you click on it, you see a filter applied. Source URLs begins with what we just selected. We call this the drill down functionality. And you can drill down into a lot of different data points. Drill down is actually a drill back or a look at the backlinks. So when we look at this domain, marketinginsidergroup.com, that has an okay detox risk, a low detox risk, and has some source power. We want to see where does this domain get links from? And so we click on this little backlink button, which starts a quick backlink analysis, a quick backlink checker analysis, which runs for a second or two and then gives you the top links, and we should be ready. Here we have the quick backlink check. What you notice immediately is that the backlink profile coverage here is very low. That's just a sample, but we see 4,000 domains, 30,000 backlinks, LRT power trust, link velocity trend being negative, not super negative, and we can get an idea of the source domains where this domain gets links from, the pages where this domain gets links from, and the keywords that it's linked for. And you notice we are suddenly in a trimmed down version of the app that again lets you look at anchor text breakdown, TLDs, domains, and pages of that domain that you have a link from. So what we're just doing is backlink research for your backlinks, not a complete crawl. This is a sample analysis, and you could get all the details down to the latest and greatest link and the worst link in the backlink profile from 10 years ago using a complete analysis. But to get an idea, to get an overview of what's going on with that domain and if that is a legit domain, this is fairly cool. And we got some filters here, and the same concept applies here, where we can see if our typical filters or spam domain lists that we created triggering here, and it looks good. So what we can do, guess what? Let's close this tab and we are back to where we were. Little indication shows us we have seen this before, and there you go. In this case, I just noticed link research to com is linked with a full URL, and that's a brand link, not a compound. So we just reclassified the keywords for that one. And while we're here, we could as well go to our keywords in anchor texts and find more cases like that. Look at that. Now, this here is a compound indeed, but when I look at all the others here, wow. So many URLs that are all classified as compound, and that's wrong. Guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to reclassify them all as brand links. And the one here up here, I know is a compound. So we are just reclassifying. And that changes the calculation of the risk and a lot of other metrics. So we want to be sure that the classification is as accurate as possible. Look, here we got some more that need to be reclassified as brand. And when I go through these, oh, here are some for our common backlinks tool, for our backlink tools, backlink profiler. These are some brand keywords that we have. But backlink analysis, yeah, that's a compound. It has a money keyword in there. And here are some link building tips. Yeah, these are compound keywords. So what we just did is we reweighted the risk. We reattributed keywords, and we see that for a normal report that's not the demo report, you would now be able to recalculate the risk, and possibly the risk would actually go down. And you would probably also see a different distribution in risk, as you see here. And you will also see that the risk drops down here. So be aware that the more precision, the more time you spend, the more accuracy you give the system, the more you get out of it. Yeah, and as a final step here in the navigation, I wanted to mention the target pages. And this lists all the pages by strength, for example, or by the number of links that it has. So you see the www link research tools com has a lot more links than this old landing page from Brighton SEO 2015 that seems to have 1.2 million links, which is a little bit scary, especially given that this domain or subdomain actually redirects now to our training. And so I want to check out what's going on with all these links, spam pattern that I would be very careful about. I would probably look into this a little bit deeper and then disavow. Let's go back to our source pages and the target pages here, get rid of the filter, and then dive deeper. You see, each of our pages has different criteria. And of course, we have a lot more metrics to enable here as well. That's it for now.